أو كالذي مر على قرية. This is another incident, and most probably it concerns also the history of the Jews, the Bani Israel. When Nebuchadnezzar destroyed Jerusalem in the late 7th century before Jesus, BC, before Christ, he killed about 600,000 Jews, and the rest of 600,000, rest 600,000, he took them to Babylonia in captivity. They remained there, some for 100 years, some for 150 years. That's the worst period of Jewish history, era of days of captivity in Babylonia. Jerusalem was ruined, absolutely ruined. Not a single soul living, not a single wall, not two bricks together. Such was the ruination of a city. Just imagine how big a city it was. It was founded by Solomon, Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, at the height of the glory and splendor of Bani Israel. That was the town. And Hazrat Sulaiman had the help of the jinns also in construction. He constructed the Haikal, the Solomon's temple. And then this was raised to the ground. Now two bricks were intact. Not a single soul was there. And then there bypassed the Prophet Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam. He wondered at that scene, how can this city again be revived? How can Allah revive this city? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him to death, kept him there for 100 years in that death condition, then revived him. And then, you know, this is the matter. Then Hazrat Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, he went to Babylonia, and then, you know, he started his call, repent, make tawbah towards Allah. And due to his call and his mission, there was the spiritual revival of Bani Israel. And then they again were given, you know, another period of glory during their history. And that is called the Maccabi power, the Maccabi Sultanate. That was the second rise that they had during their history. Anyhow, about this incident now, Hazrat Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, I feel it personally that this, although the name has not been given here, only one city and a person, but you know, this seems to me, I'm pretty sure that this is the case of Hazrat Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam. Aw kallazi marra ala qaryatin. Or have you ever considered the case of that person who passed by a town, وَهِيَ خَابِيَةٌ عَلَىٰ عُرُوشِهَا, and that town had fallen down upon its roofs, all was demolished. قَالَ أَنَّا يُحْيِي هَذِهِ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. He said, how shall Allah give this town again life after it has been dead, so badly dead, so deeply ruined? فَأَمَاتَهُ اللَّهُ مِيَةَ عَامٍ. So Allah put him to death for 100 years. ثُمَّ بَعَثَ. Then Allah again brought him to life, raised him alive. قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتَ. Allah asked him, how long have you been here? Do you have any idea? Oh Uzair, supposedly if he was Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, oh Uzair, do you have any idea how long have you been here? قَالَ لَبِثْتُ يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. He said, I've been here for one day, or maybe a part of a day. Just I had a nap. I just had, you know, a nap and nothing else. Maybe a full day has passed, and maybe a part of it. قَالَ بَلْ لَبِثْتَ مِئَةَ عَامٍ. Allah said, no, you have been here in this condition for 100 years. فَانْظُرْ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِكَ. Now see to your food that you had with you. وَشَرَابِكَ. And the drink that you had. لَمْ يَتَسَلَّهُ. They have not spoiled. I have kept them as fresh as they were before 100 years. This is my authority. I can do it. This is in my power. I am all powerful. وَانْظُرْ إِلَىٰ حِمَارِكَ. And now on the other hand, you see, just look to your ass, your donkey. And that had died, you know, and all flesh has gone, and there were only few bones scattered and nothing else. 100 years. So all those physical phenomena had happened to that dog, to that ass, but nothing had happened to the food. And we want to make you a sign for the people. And it's very clear, when he had returned to the people, to Bani Israel, they must have been astonished. This person, he was dead long before. We had no news of him. Where from he has come now? And when he must have told this story, so it would have been, I think, a very, very big sign that, you know, Allah can revive us also. If he could do this to an individual, he could do this, you can do this to a community, to a nation. وَلِنَجْعَلَكَ آيَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَالْضِجَ لِلْعِزَامِ And now see, look to the bones of your donkey, of your ass. كَيْفَ نُنْشِزُهَا How we raise them up. Join them together, raise them up as a skeleton. ثُمَّ نَكْسُوهَا لَحْمًا And then we clothe them with flesh, with muscles. فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ When everything became absolutely clear to him, قَالَ أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ Then he said and proclaimed, Now I fully know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all powerful and he can do anything that he likes.